हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू माय चैनल केमिकल इंजीनियर। आई एम सहज यादव एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द मेन सब्जेक्ट दैट इज़ द मास ट्रांसफर ऑपरेशन इन केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग टाइम लेट्स स्टार्ट मास ट्रांसफर पार्ट वन। सो इन दिस वीडियो आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द मास ट्रांसफर ऑपरेशन सब्जेक्ट इन केमिकल इंजीनियरिंग। आई विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द मेन टॉपिक्स एंड व्हाट आर the different types of mass transfer and what is mass transfer. In the upcoming videos I will be covering the full syllabus, so I hope you subscribe to the channel and so be connected. Okay, so let's start. So this is what the summary is which I will be covering in the session of videos. So I will be uploading two videos on diffusion, that is the topic of mass transfer, two videos on mass transfer coefficients, one video on dimensionless analysis of numbers in mass transfer, then two videos on drying and drying rate curve, then I will upload one video on adsorption, five videos on distillation, two videos on absorption and two videos on extraction. This is how I will be going to cover full mass transfer syllabus for BTech chemical engineer. So what is mass transfer? So the basic definition for chemical engineer to know what mass transfer is, that is, so transfer of mass, or we can say transfer of molecules. The difference between the mass and molecule I will be discussing while discussing the topic diffusion, because in mass we use term convection, while for molecules we'll use term diffusion. So I will be discussing it later. So transfer of mass or molecule from one position or one steady position or one moving position to other, that is, in order to move mass or something molecule we require mass transfer. So transfer of mass or molecule from one position to other under the influence of driving force. So this is the main topic. So driving force. So let us suppose I have one bottle on a table. Now I need to take that bottle and pass it on another table. So is it mass transfer? So the answer is no, because we are taking one object and putting it on other desk, so this is not a mass transfer operation. It is generally a transfer operation, but for mass transfer driving force is the must condition for transfer of molecule. So basically we have concentration difference, pressure difference, then we can also have the difference in composition. So mainly these three are the main driving force. We may also have difference in boiling point or difference in volatility or something like that. So what is mass transfer? So your answer should be transfer of mass or molecule from one position to other under the influence of driving force. So this is the standard definition of mass transfer. So example of mass transfer are diffusion, reverse osmosis, distillation, adsorption, extraction. In diffusion we have generally a concentration difference as the driving force. In reverse osmosis we have the pressure difference. In distillation we have the volatility or boiling point difference. In adsorption, that is the surface phenomena, we have concentration difference. In extraction we have pressure difference as a mass transfer driving of force. Alright, so in better way, mass transfer is a transport process. So generally we divide mass transfer into two, that is convective mass transfer and diffusional mass transfer. And in generally we'll use the term momentum transport and heat transport for mass transfer and heat transfer respectively. So in as we are going to study heat transfer, similar laws, physical laws are there for mass transport. For momentum, heat and mass, we all have the basic laws that is discussed in previous video. You can go to my channel and watch for the previous video. Okay, so this is it. What are mass transfer? So this is the separation processes that we are going to study in mass transfer. So that is gas adsorption and stripping, in which the solvent is the separating agent that differentiates between the absorption, that is what we have to absorb selectively. For the example, that is removal of CO2 gas from syngas. Syngas, we know that the composition of natural gas is CO plus H2 or CO2 plus H2. So CO2 plus H2, generally known as syngas. Then removal of CO2 and H2S from natural gas, then stripping. Then this is all about the gas absorption and stripping. In distillation, we'll use heat for separation. So this is actually a driving force, that is delta H. And here we have solvent, so delta C, that is the concentration difference. So the examples are crude oil distillation and fractionation of crude oil and air separation. Similarly, liquid-liquid extraction, solvent, driving forces, concentration difference used for removal of aromatics. And in pharmaceutical industry, solid-liquid extraction, also known as leaching, we have solvent as the driving force. So driving force will be the concentration. The examples are this. And in drying, we have heat and drying gas. So the difference is the temperature to differentiate. So drying of fruits, etc. are the example. In adsorption, we have the concentration as the driving force. We'll use it for separation of organic from gases and other application, ion exchange, crystallization and membrane. This all we are going to study. So I hope you will join in this video sessions. So thank you for watching the video. And this is the basic why the mass transfer is important, because all these separation steps include mass transfer. So without mass transfer, raw material can't be converted to product. So please remember well that mass transfer is of course the basic and of course the most important subject to run any chemical industry. Alright, so next video on diffusion is going to be uploaded soon. So till that time, subscribe, share and like to the channel, and do whatever you want to do, man. But please study well. Alright, thank you guys.